It would take a lot of time to describe all the details. The one thing is that we are farming biodynamically, and biodynamically requires a very responsible way of how to deal with nature. That means you can, for example, you cannot kind of specialize only into cows or only into pigs. You look at the farm as a whole organism, where you have everything. You know, people make fun of Old McDonalds Farm. Old McDonalds Farm is actually the archetypal farm which we need to redevelop as a cultural entity in our society. At the moment, we compartmentalize. Whatever you say. and just, you know, we look at the cows and we look at the pigs, and we do not see that actually as a very, very important part in this orchestra of farm animals and farm plants. So looking at the farm as a whole organism, like your own body, okay? So you have a liver, you have kidneys, you have a heart and so on, and the same thing we need to do, we need to get back to, and it's not a romantic notion. It is a necessity to understand that there's a symbiosis between all these animals, between the plants, between nature, and between the climate and so on, and to regionalize that is not romantic, it is necessary. And that is how you establish, renew the culture, and that is what I'm always trying to do, is get an understanding of, we need to renew the culture of agriculture in order to survive in the future. Old rulers knew that. If we don't have a strong, healthy agriculture, the state could never, democracy could never, or even, you know, the kingdom could never survive. And now we have given basically the control of our food to external powers. We gave it to the World Trade Organization. We gave it to other countries because they grow the food we want here. Canada? No, Toronto. Who's living in Toronto, by the way? Okay. I'll just tell you one thing. If for whatever reason the infrastructure breaks down, and I'm not talking about earthquakes or whatever. If infrastructure breaks down, in 3 days you have no food left. The shelves are, and these are official figures, the shelves are empty. Where do you go? Do you know a farmer where you want to go? There's only 2% of the farmers left. They could not feed you. So it is now on you to make sure to connect with a farmer who will then grow in that relationship with you the food and secure the food for the future for you. That is your responsibility. It's not only the farmer's responsibility. Thanks.